Morning students, today we are going to learn about something very important in the field of robotics. In the field of robotics, if you look carefully, the most important part is sensors. Why is it important? Because if you look at a human body has having 5 sensors. So you just imagine a human body with no sensors. No sensors means what? No information is going to the brain. So it means like a tiger will come and it will eat you. Nothing will happen to you. I mean, you will be dead. Okay, so something same is happening in the sensors in the robotics field. If a robot is having no sensors, it is useless. It is useless, completely useless. Okay, so what we are going to learn today is we are going to learn about sensors, the most important part. Okay, now in the sensors we have two very important parts, or you can say two important sections. You can say one is called digital section, another is called analog sensor section. In the digital section, the sensors are a bit easier to learn, but in the analog section it is a bit tough to learn. So what I am going to do is, I am not going to focus anything on the analog part today, because as you know, this is the first class of the sensors. We will be focusing on the digital part. Now if you look at the digital sensor, in the one shot I can say, the digital sensors are those sensors which senses the environment and gives the output in the form of either 0 or 1. Or you understand binary, I am trying to say that only. Means the sensors will sense the environment, it will give you either 0 or 1. Okay, now to understand this concept, let's understand with the help of one sensor. So what I am focusing is, I am focusing on IR digital sensor today. Okay, we will be learning about how this IR digital sensor works, its circuit diagram and some more important concepts regarding this sensor. Okay, and I hope you will be understanding all the concepts which I am teaching you today. Okay, now let's understand this circuit diagram. And I hope you will be understanding. What I'm going to do is, I'm going to make you first of all understand the basic parts here, and then we'll just understand the complete circuit. Okay. Now, as I have made, you can see in this circuit diagram, the most important part is our IR LED and the photodiode. Why it is important? You will understand from here. This is the basic structure of our IR sensor, something like this. Okay. This is your IR LED, and this is your photodiode. Now how it works actually, it actually senses an obstacle. How it senses an obstacle? This IR LED is what it does, it keeps on sending the IR rays outside. Okay, now what will happen? This IR rays, when it comes out, it falls on a body, on some kind of obstacle. So what will happen? You know the principle of reflection. What happens? If a rays falls on a body, it will reflect back. So when it reflects back, what happens? We keep the photodiode in such a way that maximum reflection falls on the photodiode. Now what will happen? So all the reflection which is coming on the photodiode can be accepted by this sensor. So you can keep a point in your mind that the most important part of our IR sensor is your photodiode. Why it is important? Because this is the place from where the sensor is accepting the information. Okay? Now internally what happens, this data is processed and it is sent to any kind of microcontroller. Okay, so what I will do is, I'll make you understand how this really happens. Now if you look here, what I have done, you look at the arrows. This arrow shows that IR rays are coming out. Okay, now what these arrows are showing, the IR rays which was coming out from the IR LED is reflecting on the photodiode. Now what's happening here, all the rays which is falling on the photodiode is accepted by the diode present here, which works in the reverse bias. Means if the light particles falling on this photodiode is more, the current generated will be more. Okay, now you can see the current coming from here is either going in this direction or this direction. Okay, and you might be knowing the current always follows that path where the resistance is less. Okay, now if you look here, we have kept a 10k resistance. This side is no resistance, so what will happen? The maximum current will go in this path. Okay, now if you come to the next part of the circuit, we have a variable resistor here. Variable resistor, as you know, what happens, you can change the resistance and based on that a specific voltage difference can be created. Okay, now what I have done, this current coming from here is transferred to this place, so we can have a potential difference at these two points. Similarly, we can have a potential difference at these two places. So what is happening? We are actually getting two potentials at these two places. Okay. So what I am going to do now is, in this circuit diagram, let's understand what actually is happening here. And this is actually the heart of the IR sensor. Why it is heart? Because at this place only, the digital nature of the sensor is made, or you can say it is converted here. Because whatever information you are getting here is analog. Fine. Now what actually this is actually an IC. The IC name you can see here, what's written here, LM358. Okay. So LM358 IC is nothing, it's actually two op-amp. So what do you mean by op-amp? Op-amp is a very, very, very important device in the field of electronics. Why? Because it has lots of jobs. Here we are going to use it as a voltage comparator. Means it can compare two potentials. Okay. So the two potentials which we have is one coming from the photodiode and one coming from the variable resistance. Okay. Now the op-amp works on a very simple rule, and the rule is something like this. We have two potentials, one is called V plus and another is called V minus. Now if the V plus is more than V minus, we'll get output as 1, and if the V plus is less than V minus, we'll get as 0. Okay, now just see what is going to happen here. If the voltage generated at this place is more, means what? The obstacle is nearer to you and V plus is more, and we are going to get 1 here. Okay, based on this rule, check it out. Okay, means what? You are actually sensing the sensor. You are actually sensing. Means 1 means what? Your sensor is sensing and is sending 1 out. Means you are telling the microcontroller that I am sending 1 now. Okay. Now let's see the some other case. In other case, let it be like this. Your wall is at a distance of, let it be 20 centimeter. Means the IR rays which is falling on the wall is coming back. But as the distance is more, so less particles will be coming on this photodiode, means the potential generated at V plus will be of this case, means it will be less than V minus. Okay. Now if it is less, it means we will be getting what? 0 here. Means if this is the second case where I am trying to say that this sensor is telling I am not sensing anything. Okay. So what will happen if your sensor is sensing? It will send 1 based on this rule. If it is not sensing, means suppose the obstacle is at a very high, far distance, it will follow this rule and it will send 0. Okay. Now can you just think properly? I mean, if you look very carefully, can you see we are getting 0 and 1 here? Yes or no? Means you are getting 0 and 1 means what? You are actually defining the digital nature of the sensor. Means if your sensor is sensing, you are sending 1. If your sensor is not sensing, you are sending 0. Okay. To make it more accurate, what we have done, in the sensor only, we have attached a small part of circuit here. What it does is, if the sensor is sensing, here I have kept one IR LED. So what will happen? If you are getting 1 here, this LED will glow. If you are getting 0 here, this LED will not glow. Okay. Means what will happen? You will also be able to see whether your sensor is sensing or not. Okay. Means if this LED is glowing, means your sensor is sensing and is sending 1 to the brain or to the microcontroller. If it is sending 0, means it is not glowing and it is sending 0. And the most important part of this sensor is it works on real time. Means it always works. If obstacle is very near, it will send 1. If obstacle is very far or it is away from it, it is sending 0. Thank you.